people frightened of the water, and it's true. And that's why they won't go swimming.
I always tell them when they ask me if you can swim, I say yes, I can swim like a brick. I go straight to the bottom. I've seen great swimmers in Jamaica. I don't know why they have this theory about black people can't swim.
I ain't gonna lie, looking at it from up here, it's looking a bit daunting. It's looking like I'm feeling like I have regrets. That's really deep. I was really coming into this thinking, yeah, I got this. I don't know what I've got myself into. I feel like now's the best time for me to learn because I'm starting to have the means to actually travel the world. I need to be swimming in open water. So if not now, then when?
I'm thinking that in 8 weeks, God willing, I'm gonna be like these people here, just swimming for bants, like gliding through the water. You know, like some people, they go for a jog and they run all the time, and I want this to be my jog. I want this to be something I can just do.
It's just been a really long time. I've avoided it for a while. I wanna be able to lay back in the water and just like, feel at one and feel at peace, which I can't do now.
How are we doing, man? You ready? Yep. Begin with. Put your hands to one side of the body. Yeah, and then twist and slide in. There we go. Cold, isn't it?
A little bit cold, so we can start walking.
I feel like coming here today, before actually entering the pool, and just the smell of chlorine, it ended up being a trigger. I had like little flashbacks to those moments, but it's just about trying to keep as calm as possible.
In terms of my approach for my first day of swimming, it's giving success, it's giving Olympic, it's giving Michael Phelps. Would I use a strong word as skill to describe how I move in the water? No. I like to say I travel in the water. If swimming is going from A to B, I can go from A to lowercase a. I can move within the water. And I'm hoping to graduate to swimming.
I really enjoyed it. You know what? I didn't know he'd be in the water with us, and that really gives you like a level of support. In all the swimming lessons I've done before, you just have someone on the side, and you're like, I don't even know if you can swim. But like, it was good to have him with you.
My family is Dominican. I actually went there in year six. One of the things I would have liked to have experienced is swimming in the Caribbean Sea. They're all frolicking in it. It's common for Caribbeans to do so. I've always wanted to be a part of what they were doing, but I never really felt comfortable because of past experiences. That day they were in the pool and I wasn't, I kind of felt like I was letting the family down. Not being able to swim was added on top of their perceptions of me as the Western boy. When I was 18, I made a decision to grow out my hair. Everyone was vehemently against it. I feel like part of the reason I got it was locks being considered a dreadful hairstyle, especially for black people. I wanted to make a point of saying, this is who I am, and I'm proud of this. I would always use my locks as an excuse to not be in water, because whenever my hair's in water, it's like a sponge. Finding a swim cap to actually cover my hair has played a big part actually getting into the water.
When I was born, my parents were made aware that it was a possibility I could have sickle cell. By 7 months, they had confirmed it. It does predominantly affect people of African or Caribbean descent. I have a lower immune system. My red blood cells that should be shaped like a full moon are shaped like a sickle moon. They can get clogged in the highways of our blood. That means no oxygen getting from one place to another. And when that happens, it's called a crisis. I have a procedure called red cell blood exchange, which is a blood transfusion that decreases the amount of sickle cells present in my body, which decreases the chance of a crisis and gives me a better quality of life. When I was around 12, I went on like a summer camp and people were teaching me how to swim. And I came home and I was just like, oh, Mom, I want to show you. Went to the leisure center. I was swimming up and down. You know, I was giving. Unfortunately, coming from the cold, wet environment into another cold, wet environment, which is just Manchester weather, I woke up screaming in pain. I could not move my legs. It was excruciating. And I was in and out of hospital for about 2 months. Having that extreme crisis, I had to relearn how to walk and emotionally and mentally recover from such a physical trauma, from doing something that gave me joy, feeling like it was ending my life. I never had that level of disruption to my life because of sickle cell, something that maybe had me absent of school for like 2 weeks, but 8 months. Like, how can you still have the same level of innocence? Granted, I did get through like the whole Friends box set, so it wasn't all bad. Do you know what I mean? Balance. But I felt betrayed by my body, and I live by the rules my body has set for me.
When I was a kid, my dad used to take us to Wavelength swimming pool, and we would go swimming most Saturdays. They used to have these artificial waves that would come on every hour. So you'd be swimming, having a good time, and then suddenly the waves would come on. And in that situation, I would begin to drown. I always felt like a sinker because I was always at the bottom of the pool. I just didn't feel like someone who could float. My family is from Sierra Leone. My parents, they just were not swimmers. I remember so many times my mum would be like, don't go in the water. The stories go that in rivers and in the sea, a woman will appear from the water. She has the legs of a fish, and then she comes out and she's a human. But she takes you into the water. And my mum has got stories of when she was a child and she was in the water and she felt like she was being dragged in. And in her mind, that is a mammy water.
I think on this journey, I found that being in the water and having the fears of drowning be present, but persevering through it, is what was surprising to me. My biggest challenge was around week 4, when I was trying to lie on my back, my body would seize up. I was just like, I don't know if this is going to be something I'm going to overcome. That was the hardest part.
Doing these lessons in this safe environment where my health was prioritized, it took away the reason why I didn't do it. And now I feel like I can.
Like, now I'm in water, it's amazing. I love being in water, which is something I thought I'd never say. I guess in some ways it can be quite therapeutic. It's very calming. I feel like now I have a duty to encourage other Black people to push themselves to learn how to swim.
When I get in the water now, I feel free and I feel calm and I feel relaxed.
Your body's yours in the water, you're just working with it. Now, I'm not a sinker, I'm just someone who can swim now.
I'll be honest, going into today, I was feeling a little bit anxious because I'd never jumped off any diving board. When I hit that water, I felt so victorious. I have had times in lessons where I've been struggling to walk, I've not been feeling well, and in the water, it all fades away and I'm just a different person. And learning to swim has been so freeing. I have sickle cell disease and I can swim.
The fear we have is the fear we created. And that is what is haunting all of us. Everybody, they fail to recognize that. There's nothing you cannot do. Fear is just the word.